Hi everyone, I'm Yuki Nezumi. Nice to meet you. And thanks for stopping by. Big thanks to all of you who always watch and support my channel. But I'm sorry, if you are already playing games, you might not need this video. But feel free to stick around anyway. In today's video, I'll walk you through how to get Epic Games running on Ubuntu. I'll also show you how to fix common errors that might pop up during the setup process. So let's figure it out together and start gaming! This guide is based on Ubuntu 24.04 LTS. Step 1. Install NVIDIA drivers. I'm using an NVIDIA GPU, so the first thing we need to do is install the correct driver. By the way, I've added timestamps in the description, so feel free to jump to the part you need. Let's start by updating the package list with this command: sudo apt-update. This updates the repository info. Next, let's upgrade all packages to the latest version. Sudo apt-upgrade -y. The -y option just means yes to all prompts. It can be quick or it can be take a while. Now let's check if our system recognizes the NVIDIA GPU, lspci, pipe, grep, -i, NVIDIA. Looks like my RTX 3050 is detected. Awesome! This command lists all PCI devices and filters for NVIDIA, regardless of case. Let's check if the NVIDIA driver is already installed. nvidia-smi. Oops, command not found. That means the driver isn't installed yet, even though the system detects the GPU. If the driver was already installed, you'd see a summary window like this. Ubuntu 24 sometimes installs the driver during OS setup, so if you already see it, you can skip this step. Let's search for available NVIDIA drivers. Sudo ubuntu-drivers devices. From the results, pick the one labeled recommended. In my case, that's NVIDIA driver 570, so let's install it. Sudo apt install nvidia-driver-570-y. I make spelling mistakes many times. Once the installation finishes, reboot your machine. Sudo reboot. After rebooting, check again. nvidia-smi. Nice! The GPU driver is working and fully recognized. Step 2. Set up Epic Games with Lutris. Now, let's get ready to run Epic Games on Linux. We'll use a great tool called Lutris. It's probably the easiest way to run Epic Games on Ubuntu. Let's install it. Sudo apt install -y Lutris. However, with the relationship between Ubuntu 24 and Lutris, there are some issues. Unfortunately, they haven't been fixed yet. Maybe. So let's launch Lutris in debug mode. Lutris-d. Follow the on-screen prompts to install the Epic Game Store. And now, a warning appears. The installation just won't finish and you need to hit a boot. Why does this happen? It turns out the issue is with Wine, the Windows emulator Lutris uses. Ubuntu 24 doesn't support 32-bit packages by default, and Wine needs those to work properly. Let's fix that. First, enable 32-bit architecture. Sudo dpkg --add-architecture i386. Then update your package list again. Sudo apt-update. Now install both 64-bit and 32-bit Wine plus some additional required libraries. Sudo apt-install -y wine64 wine32 libsound2-plugins:i386 libstl2-2:0-0:i386 libdbus-1-3:i386 libsqlite3-0:i386 Now your system is fully prepped to run 32-bit Windows apps on Ubuntu 24. Let's try installing Epic Games again. Launch Lutris in debug mode. Lutris-D. I made a mistake. Yes, follow the same steps as before. Yes, this time the install script runs correctly. Step 3. Fixing the Epic Games launch crash. Let's try launching the Epic Games Store. The window suddenly closes. What happened? Let's check the logs. Turns out there is a problem reading a manifesto file. This error only shows up in debug mode, so it took a while to figure out. I couldn't pinpoint the exact cause, but I found a simple fix that works like magic. It might be a permission issue during the initial setup. If we change the executable path, Lutris reinitializes Epic Games and that fixes the problem. Here's what to do. Launch Lutris in debug mode again. Lutris-D. Right-click the Epic Games Store entry. Then go to Configure, Game Options, change the executable path. Rename the folder Epic Games to something like Epic Games 1. Merge the directory name in the file system as well. Epic Games 1. Epic Games 1. Now launch Epic Games from Lutris. It might crash once more, that's normal. Close Lutris and try launching it again, the same way. Lutris-D. Play. Yes, it works. Once it's initialized properly, the bug doesn't come back. Now just revert the folder name and path back to normal, and that's it. You're ready to install and play your games. Enjoy your gaming life, and see you next time. Bye bye.